Reading Tool wins. I'm Eddie, and I'm George, and welcome back to the Windmill War Crosses. You might not know by just clicking on this video, but basically 3 minutes ago we were filming the reaction to The Way of the Fire. So it burned us.
Yes.
And it turned us to ashes, which means now we are one with the ashes. But this is one with the shadows, and we don't know if we're gonna become that too. Package.
Well, shadows have around the same color as ashes.
Yes. You could say ashes are shadows of what used to be. Package.
Package.
Package. Package.
Are you ready? No.
Okay. Do the death of those drums!
Wow!
Not gonna stop. I don't actually know if it happens. We'll be right back.
He's overcompensating.
For what?
Lack of solos in the previous time.
There's a decent amount of solos in that time, too.
It's the time, it's the solo on time and the licks on Sons of Winter and Stars in part 4. That's it. He has two sections of solo.
That was a very, very good solo.
And we already... It was two solos in this one as well. The first one was very long.
Yes.
Bro! Okay, so it's more like mid-tempo this time around. Yeah. I feel like within time 2, this is what Land of Snow and Sorrow was within time 1.
Yeah.
But not only, because it is still more high energy. You still get double kicks and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And yeah, you said it, and I have to troll people online, because some of y'all in the Winter Sun fan group were complaining about the drum sound.
They were?
Yeah, they were.
We beefing,
yeah. The people were saying that it sounds too, I don't remember if processed or compressed or, you know, the kind of shit that people say when they want to say that things sound too good.
Yeah.
So that's what that meant.
No, it sounds absolutely massive. It sounds like it could crush a mountain.
It also, this one, I think, also harkens a bit more back to the debut album in terms of the, like, harmonies and the grit in the guitar sound.
I think it has a bit of, like, Sleeping Stars, Sadness and Hate sort of energy in it.
Yeah.
Also with the vocals, like, the really gritty vocals.
Yeah.
It really has, and the sort of hazy vibe, mm-hmm. that's a bit kind of like Sleeping Stars, that hypnotic feeling.
Yeah, and that also connected with what I was able to catch from the lyrics, because he was describing, like, things and shadows that are staying, like, either in the back of your mind or around you when you sleep at night, and they haunt you for the rest of your life, and they will be there all the time.
Yeah, I think the song's about letting go.
Could be.
Because he describes all those things, and then he says, but I must leave the past behind.
Yeah, I think
what he means by that is, I gotta release the album already.
Yeah.
And stop complaining about what I didn't do right yet.
He did plenty right.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And one more thing I really like. You get the sort of raspy Yachty vocals, the more raspy cleans. Like cleans, but not really, really cleans.
Yeah.
What I hear for the first time ever, I think, in this song is not only that he does those kind of vocals, but he does the sort of, like, melodic fluctuations on them from the Japanese, Chinese influences on that type of vocal.
Yeah.
And that was really cool.
Yeah, and the other thing he does is just fade it to a scream.
Yeah.
Towards, I think towards the end of the last chorus he did that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We have a bunch left. And I kind of want to listen to it, but I also don't want to, because I don't want this first listening experience to end.
We're not even halfway through yet, so
uh-huh.
We still got some to go.
That feels good.
Are we done yet?
No.
So if you enjoyed this reaction, we greatly appreciate the likes and shares. And if you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe with bells on.
Thank you very much for stopping by. We hope you enjoyed your stay, and we'd love to see you back at the windmill very soon.
Horses out.